I'm Leo Espinoza, a state soil specialist with the University of Arkansas Systems Division of Agriculture, and I'd like to talk to you about soil testing today. The numbers in your soil test report represent an estimate of the amount of plant available nutrient in a soil. The concentration of nutrients, for instance, potassium, not only vary across a field, but it can also vary depending on weather conditions. Within a field, potassium levels can vary due to changes in topography, texture, or drainage. One needs to keep in mind that these conditions don't hold true for every field in Arkansas, as cultural practices are major drivers in the variability we observe within a field. Potassium levels can also be affected by weather conditions. For instance, under extended dry conditions, potassium levels will tend to be lower than normal. So we may have soils that will show higher amounts of potassium, and we may have some other soils that will show lower amounts of potassium than normal. Keep in mind that soil test levels typically do not change dramatically from year to year, particularly if the soil test levels are medium to optimal. So how do we know if a particular soil test result is accurate or not? And here is where the real value of soil testing comes into play. The real value of soil testing is not on the ability on running one sample or the value associated with just one sample. The real value is on the ability of developing a history of nutrient levels for a particular field for as long as a farmer has worked such field. If a farmer has a soil test, let's say for the last 10 years, he can easily see whether or not a particular soil test result is way off of his historical average. Keep in mind also that a 10% variability in soil test result is probably considered normal. So don't guess soil test. Thank you very much.